Yeah, and Salvia is such a crazy one too. I just got permission to share this interview. I'm going to be posting it in the next couple of days of a Salvia experience, and it's not the only one of its kind either. Long story short, because it's about a 20-minute video, a guy who was a Mormon living in Alaska on Christmas Day took a huge hit of salvia, obviously one of those crazy potent extracts, and all of a sudden came to face down in the water and woke up to three people on a boat who claimed that they knew him and that he was like water skiing, and he fell. And by the time they got to him, he was face down in the water by about 3 minutes. And then he realizes that these three people are claiming to be his friends that have known him his whole life, and that he just basically had a near-death experience from a water skiing accident, but he knew the whole time. Well, I'm in Alaska, and in this experience, he's in a town called Tyler, Texas, that he did not know existed, he says. And long story short, they took him to urgent care, and he's telling them, y'all aren't real. This is crazy. I just smoked salvia. Doctor said he's okay. Bring him home to an apartment where he has this whole alternate parallel reality. He said he looks slightly different. He was married in real life. He said he wasn't married and didn't have kids in this experience. And then he said, like, days went by, and he was like, nothing is psychedelic. I'm just in this alternate fucking world. And he's like, I got to go to work. And he's like, they tell me, get dressed, you got to come to work. Long story short, he goes to work, is telling everyone at work, none of this is real. I'm on a drug right now, like, da da da. And like, people were starting to get concerned. People were telling him he had brain damage and all this. And well, this man claims that he lived a really regular life, including starting a band, everything. He said that as the days and weeks went on, he started accepting that he just had brain damage and that he had amnesia and didn't remember his prior life, and that somehow the accident caused him to formulate these memories of his wife and kids. But then he was like, it would trip me out because I would watch certain movies I know I watched with my wife and kids in Alaska and this and that. But he's like, ultimately, I finally began accepting it. And then he said, one random day, 8 years into living this parallel life, he said he suddenly felt the same physical sensation that he felt that landed him in that body, and where he said the molecules that made up his body didn't affect the molecules of the ground he was standing on, and he felt this crazy sensation of falling upwards. And he said, after all of this, accepting this was his life for 8 years, living every day mundane, no psychedelia about it, he pops into his body in his brother's basement on Christmas, having just smoked salvia, and he was seizing, he peed himself. And when he asked them how long he had been there for, they said, you were having a seizure for about 45 seconds. And he
Wow.
experienced that as an entire 8 years of living in a town that he later confirmed was a real place, Tyler, Texas. This was one of the most interesting parts to me. When they're asked, did you drive at any point in this 8 years? Did you go to the town where you were from, some town in Utah? And he said he drove there like 1,000 miles, and nothing was the same as how he remembered. He said the high school was called something different. It was truly just some kind of really strange story. And he said he started bawling, crying when he realized he was right the whole time, that whole 8 years, everything. And he said his wife came in and was like, dude, you're ruining Christmas, as he was just like trying to shake back from this profound experience. And you can see in this dude's face, like, he's not fabricating any of this. This was his experience, And it's just like, experiences like that are so beyond unexplainable. And it's interesting how the body that he jumped into was having a near-death experience face down in the water when he assumed that position. There's so many questions that opens up that even, I mean, DMT doesn't open up. I haven't heard of that one at all on DMT or ayahuasca or anything else.